Hi guys, this is Kieran from Street Soccer International. Don't forget to subscribe, hit that bell notification button because we are doing some basic freestyle tutorials for you. I can do a bit of freestyle, I'm not a professional, but I can teach you the basics and help you learn some of the skills I've learned in freestyle with some of the advice and tips that I've learned. The first one today, what we're going to do is the very basic foot stall. It's one of the basics you can learn just to get your control a little bit better, and it actually helps you in regular game if you understand the basic control. So the foot stall is simply just roll the ball onto your foot, lift it up on the toes, lift the ball up and balance it, and try and hold it for as long as you want. When I first started doing it, I could only hold it a few seconds, and it's just learning to get the control. The best thing you can understand is you got to sort of bend your other knee as well. If you're not so comfortable at rolling it straight up onto your toes, a step you can use is take your hand, roll the ball onto your toes and lift it up. What you're trying to do is actually press the ball against your shin using your toe here, which allows it to create grip and balance. Once you're comfortable at getting it from on the floor, rolling it on up the toes, lifting up, pressing it against the shin and holding it, try it with your weaker foot. Get used to doing it with your weaker foot, yeah? Does it have to be perfect? Just practice it. It's a good thing from there, if you want to learn to use this motion to control the ball, it's very good. Remember, bend your other knee and a little drop, and just try and position your foot so it already got into that foot stall position, and you can just catch, yeah? Once you feel comfortable doing it, then do it from kick-ups. Both sides, always work both sides. The best bit of advice I can give you is if you start working both sides in freestyle straight away, it really helps you. I didn't do it at the start and it took me a long time to build my confidence up with my left foot. So the best tip I can give you is start to work your weaker foot straight away. What I'm going to do is just bring Silas in. So something a little different just to show you. Silas can do some of these movements, but he doesn't know them all as good. He's more of a regular footballer, but we're just going to see how Silas gets on. So can you do the foot stall? So he's rolling the ball on to his toes and he's just balancing. Look, if the ball moves, he's reacted to the ball, he moved with the ball and he's got good comfort. Can you actually switch it to your other foot? Yeah, oh, nearly. Good. Nearly, yeah, so he's having a go with his weaker foot. And again, just a reminder, because he's more of a footballer, and if you've seen that Messi Pannas recently, he sort of uses this touch as well, is if you're using a footballer and if you're controlling the ball, so I'm just going to chuck the ball to Silas. Remember to bend your other knee to control it, yeah? So remember to bend that knee and you get a good comfortable catch. You don't have to use it actually as a catch if you just throw it. Again, if you just touch the ball, you get a good touch. So a freestyle move, a basic stall, a freestyle move is very good at building control up as well in regular football. A lot of people think these don't transfer, but it's practice. The movements and learning to understand your body will help you in regular football if you're more of a footballer as well, and it's just a little bit of fun. Hi guys, thank you for watching this week's video. If you haven't learned last week's move, go back and check that one out. I'll leave a link in the description for that. Also be back Friday for Yofi's top 3 videos and come back Sunday for some multiple skills videos.